Hey guys, my name is Nala and I am the lovely owner of Love.nxlaa. Welcome and welcome back to my channel. Before we get into this video, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Also, make sure you like, comment, and share with your aunties, your uncles, your cousins, and Jimmy down the block. But without further ado, let's hop into this video, shine my loves. Y'all, can you tell the difference? I dye my hair black. She's black. Yeah. You know, it's winter time. I told you guys I've had my hair dyed since I was about 15. Freshman year of high school, I got highlights and my hair has been colored ever since. I have not seen my hair black since freshman year of high school. I'm currently almost 23 years old. And I was ready for that color to go. I was tired of it. As you know, back in January, I dyed my full hair like copper with blonde highlights. Balayage type of situation, and then I just got real tired of it last week. I was just really like, it's giving childish, it's not giving grown, and it's not giving sexy, so we have to dye it. And I was hesitant because I've been told to go to a colorist to go get my hair done, go to somebody who does hair to get it dyed. But y'all, we are living in trying times. Why am I paying $350 just for a color and highlights for a whole head? Not including a press. No, that was a hard pass for me. So I said, you know what? We're gonna take the leap of faith. I'm gonna take the leap of faith. It's hair, it'll grow back. And we're gonna roll with the bunches. But if you guys want to find a way to achieve hair black that's colored, I'm going to share it with you in this video. So stay tuned and I'll see you guys in the next clip.
Okay, I'm like, I keep freaking out. I'm like, girl, you look a mess. And it's because I know I do. Because, yeah, girl, I'm dyeing my hair today. You know, I've been wanting to dye my hair for a minute. Yeah, hold on. I'm just getting my flakes all up in my business. Okay, but I'm dyeing it to a natural black color. As you can see, like, my roots are a natural black. I've been on YouTube like trying to figure out how to properly dye your hair black, because if you don't know, when you dye your hair black, if it's not done properly, you'll get like this green tint in your hair, and that's not what I want. Now, they did say you have to do a color fill. A lot of people go from being a redhead to black hair because that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to go fully redhead and then put the black dye on top of it. So I'm going to be dyeing it red first, but I have to comb it out and then let the dye sit on there, and then we're gonna get into the black dye. So yeah, it's happening. Okay, all right, so I'll see you guys in the next clip. Okay, so now that I have sectioned and detangled my hair, I'm gonna go in with Vaseline literally all over me. Because I've seen girls on TikTok and YouTube that get this dye all over them. Nah, not in this household. So I'm gonna get this and smear it all over my face, all over my neck, my sideburns, and my forehead. So I got the Adora dye in the color Ruby Red, and I got the color 64. You have the measuring cup from the beauty supply store. They have measurements in it. I'm gonna fill it up to the 10. The 10, or just like the half. Okay, yeah, that's 10. That's actually not 10. It's a little above 10. When did make a door smell like this? Wow, this smells good. Ah! Don't start with me. Oh. Okay. When did a door smell like this? Wow, this smells actually pretty good. Wow, they all smell like, you know. Now I'm gonna take the 20 volume developer and fill this up to the 99. Well, which is this whole thing. I can't even ask Google how long this has to sit in here because she doesn't want to connect to the Wi-Fi. So we're just gonna wing it. All right, we about to get to it. So what I think I'm gonna strategize and do, I'm gonna part the section, run it through. I'm only sticking it to like the parts that are colored because she said not to put it on the darkest part of your hair since it's already almost the color of the dye. So I'm gonna just do the brown parts and yeah. So now that I'm done, honestly, it wasn't as messy as I thought it would be, which I am kind of proud about. Of course, you know, you got a little here and there, but not as much as I thought it would be. So now I am going to set my alarm. She said for 30 minutes, I'm gonna let this sit. Then I'm gonna go and wash it out, and then I have to come back and blow dry my hair because then we gonna stand on business, okay? We standing on business. So, well then, dye it black. But for now, put the timer on for 30 minutes, let it sit, rinse it out, blow dry, and then we're gonna do the second process of dyeing. Y'all, I'm about to do a reveal in 2 seconds. But let me preface this by saying, if this color does not, oh my Jesus, y'all. I don't know what to say. I know what to say. Jesus, please. Please. So it's looking like it took to the color, like the color where the brown was. And that's what we wanted. So I'm not complaining about that. Cause I did put some like on here too, but like not that much. Cause I said like my hair was already like a natural black color. So I'm about to part it and blow dry it. So yeah. I'm about to blow dry my hair. I'll see you guys in the next clip. All right, so now that I have blow dried my hair, I am going in once again with the Vaseline to make sure, because, you know, I mean, like I said, it's not as messy as I thought it would be. So that's always good. Just lathering up. Putting it all on my face. I know this is not good for your skin, but we just need it temporarily for right now. Go ahead and part. Like I said, I have already curated the, well, curated, I just poured it in here. I've already poured this, the activator into the dye. Wow, okay. So, I'm gonna use the same brush. I washed it out and everything, make sure it's dry. So the, well, not, it's not super dry, it's dry enough. So now I'm gonna do the same thing like I did before. Section it, pin this up, and then, oh, the comb. I'll do each root first and then do the ends. Cause this, she said, since it's already processed, it's gonna process faster with the dye, if that makes any sense. So you wanna start from the root and do the roots first, and then go back in and do the ends. Cause since the ends are already have been processed with the bleach, well, not the bleach, but with the filler, it's more activated and it'll turn brown quicker. Hopefully I explained that properly. Okay, so now that the dye is dying, we're gonna let it sit in the hair. They sit specifically for 25 minutes. Now, since I did this side first, I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm going to set my alarm or timer for 25 minutes. I'm gonna go clean up everything. I'm gonna wash this out in the shower because I will let the deep conditioner that they gave in the box sit in my hair after I wash the dye out. I also wore my own. Not too fond of or keen of Cantu. I got, it was the cheapest thing. I got the Cantu Avocado Hydrating Moisture Mask. And I'm gonna use some of this as well if all of the cream of nature doesn't cover my hair. Wash it out very thoroughly. Like I said, let the mask sit on, and then I'm gonna come back, show you guys the final result. And blow dry and flat iron my hair. But I went to TJ Maxx and I got the Chai Heat Protectant 44 Barbie X Collection 44 Iron Guard. And I'm going to use this, and I'm going to use the Wow. They had a sale at Sephora, it was $12. This one is for curly hair, and this one is just the average one, I guess, for straight hair. I am in the process of trying to bring my curls back to life, especially in the front. Yeah, my curls haven't been curling in the front. And since it is winter time, you know, with silk press season, right? So I've been blow drying and flat ironing my hair a little bit more, especially since I am someone who struggles with psoriasis, and I have to make sure my hair is dry. I can't leave it wet at all. So I'm using all the heat protectant. I'm gonna buy one more. I'm going to buy the Tresemme heat protectant, so I'll have three. I'm almost kind of like running out of these. Do all that I told you, and I'll come back and show you guys the final product. This is black. This don't even look like a natural black. This looks black.
I made sure I got the back of my head, y'all. Did I? I think I did. I don't know. Maybe
y'all see. But with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next clip. I would say I'm sorry about the lighting, but I'm kind of not. It is currently 6:40 here on the East Coast, almost 5 o'clock. Haven't eaten since breakfast this morning. But y'all, I know it sounds like I'm not excited. I am. It's just like I'm kind of over the whole process. Like I said, I started this at like 11:30, almost 12 o'clock. 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's been 4 hours. Doesn't feel like it, but yeah, I'm ready to go downstairs and get my steak dinner, surf and turf dinner meal, and watch something on TV, you know? And the fact that I still have to blow dry this and flat iron it and have to do it precisely, it's kind of eating me up really well. Really, really well. So, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 1. Yeah. I'm looking at it now. I'm seeing it now. My hair is black. I honestly can't see the back of it. I'm trying to see, because I have more dye left over. I'm not re-dyeing it again today. I need to get my hair a rest. I am fortunately one of those people that when they dye their hair, it actually flourishes when it's dyed. In some odd reason, like, my curls pop out more. I don't know what that is. Somebody in the comments tell me below. But yeah. I don't think I miss any parts. I might go back in maybe at a later date with the rest of this dye. Because it has, like, when you look at it in the light, a slight brown undertone, but it's not that deep for me, honestly. So what I'm about to do, I am about to section my hair in 4 sections and spray the Color Wow Dream Coat. And then I'm going to blow dry them in sections so that it can be more concentrated, I guess you can say. Then I'm going to go downstairs and eat, watch a little TV, come back. I'm going to stay with the same 4 sections. Spray the chai on here and then flat iron it. So yeah, my hair is wow. Now, for a long time I haven't dyed my hair black. I stuck with the color because, well, coloring my hair like copper and stuff like that, because I don't know, I always felt like black made me look like a witch. However, that was a preconceived notion that somebody had put in my head a while back. So I was like, oh, I do look like a witch with black hair. So I never dyed my hair. Joke's on you. I'm actually feeling it though. My curls look good in the back. The front could be better, but you know, the front is always the problem area for me. But enough procrastinating. I'm about to section it, do what I gotta do, and to make it do what it do. So now that I'm done with this part of the hair, we're gonna go almost in this part of the hair. I'm not gonna montage this because it's literally gonna be the same thing. I'll come back to you guys when I'm ready to flat iron this baby and show you guys the final product. This is the final product. Can you tell I'm in love? Can you tell I'm in love? Man, she eats. I hope that it was helpful to you if you are someone who is looking to dye their hair. Honestly, if you follow this step by step, you'll be fine. You will be okay. If I can do it, honey, you can do it too. Okay, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.